Well, traders, I'm going to finish up today $13,745, just three trades as you can see here, BABA, ABNB and ZM. I start with my losing trade in BABA. Well, I tried to short a stock which was very, very strong today. The market did come down and the daily of BABA seemed to me like it's going to come down. I was definitely wrong. Well, that's the idea of day trading. If you're wrong, just have a reasonable stop loss and just move out. That's it. So although BABA is moving up like hell, I mean, had my stop there, it was a good size trade. So as you can see here, I had just over 2 points loser in BABA and I moved out and that's it. So nothing to say about this one anymore. So just the ZM trade was kind of interesting. ZM is, if you can, we look at the daily soon, but if you take a look at the daily, that's the reason I wanted to short ZM. It looked to me like ZM should come down. However, ZM was moving higher and higher. At the same time, I saw the market coming down and I thought, well, ZM should give up to the market. And I was looking for an opportunity to short it. The opportunity came under 356 right over here. And initially it came down just a bit and then moved higher. You may remember this move. If you were with me on this trade, it is very, very possible that some of you couldn't hold to that because the stock was really spiking up like crazy here. These are 1 minute candles and look at this green candle here. And the next one was actually just after the first one, just took me over my planned stop loss. My planned stop loss was 359 and I was supposed to go out over 359. That's the whole number. But since that was a spike, I let it move up a little bit more and I'm so glad I did because look at the end result. So you see, the stock is really, was really spiking up and down like crazy. And you're not supposed to be moving out of a stock that is spiking up against you. I mean, when it spikes down and puts you in green territory, you should take a partial. But if it spikes on the wrong way, then you should let it calm down a little bit. Don't move out on spikes. That's why you shouldn't normally have a hard stop in the system. You should be using what we call a mental stop. So sometimes you use a stop. If ZM would have gradually moved up to 359, which was my planned stop, just moves up a little bit, comes down a little bit, moves up a little bit more, slowly moving to the 359, maybe over some kind of a technical formation, I would have moved up out over 359. But when a stock is just spiking up, it could be just one buyer who's buying a few thousand shares and then the stock is moving higher. You never know where it's going to stop. That's the problem, of course, because you don't know what's coming over the 359. It could have moved over the highs. I could have had a very unpleasant loser there. But my experience tells me and taught me during the many years that I'm trading, over 20 years now, actually just about to say 21 years in a few days. So my experience taught me that when a stock is spiking, doesn't matter which direction, when it's spiking in your favor or in the other way, it's likely, very, very likely to bounce and you probably could get a better exit if you just wait a little bit. So if it's bouncing up, let's just assume I need to move out. Let's just assume it's going to continue higher. I could still get a better exit. Like it's going to spike up, going to come down. I'm going to watch it moving up slowly. And then I could have a stop possibly where I planned it originally or even a better price. So the thing is with stocks which are spiking, you should wait until it comes down a little bit and then make your decision according to the technical formation, not according to just someone who just clicked the button, a fat finger and bought hood, I don't know how many shares. And that really worked out in ZM. Now, as it failed to move higher, I didn't think it's going to fail. I thought I would wait a little bit, then it has a very good chance to just come up again. Not necessarily spike up again, but come up again and take me out. I thought that would be more likely, in fact. But the market kept coming down. If you watch the S&P, you can see that the S&P kept coming down. And at that point, ZM should have, you know, they don't always do. But 60% of the stocks that you're trading is coming from market direction. And the market was coming down, and I thought ZM should come down again. So when ZM failed to move higher and came down again through the 356, that was a good area to add once more, because at that point, I knew it could be trusted. Once it failed to move higher and came back down again, there's a nice technical formation here, especially here under the 355 area, then I knew that it's likely to be trusted. In fact, the area to add is more likely 355. I had a good feeling at the 356, so I added at that point. Now, once more, you never add to a losing trade. For example, you don't wait until it moves up and then you are at a very unpleasant loss and then you start adding to your short because you think it's going to come down. The fact is, when it's up here, it's more likely to continue higher. Well, ZM didn't. I'm glad it didn't. But you don't add at that point. You never add to a losing trade. Once it came down again under 356, which was my entry point earlier, that was the point I could have added to the trade. So I added 50%. That's why ZM just became a $17,000 winner, which is my biggest winner, because I was adding. And of course, the way ZM came down, it did take me out with my last 400 shares over here. But anyway, it worked out very nicely and it continues to come down. So there's nothing wrong about ZM. Well, I don't want to talk much about Airbnb. I felt like Airbnb should come down today. I shorted it somewhere at the top. It was a dangerous thing to do, but it worked out. I don't think there's anything educational to talk about Airbnb. And actually, I want to spend just two more minutes about LAZR, the trade which, in fact, I did not take. I did post it in the trading room. Due to the fact that Matthew was it who posted it in our trading room, and he noticed that something going on in LAZR. Now, I do want to talk about that. I just used the wrong order. I had my ZM trade here over here, and I used my 400 shares stop, and I left my stop order on my order. So I left the stop order on, and that means that once I wanted to move into LAZR, the stop order just bounced in my face, and I missed the entry point. I didn't want to chase it up, but let's talk about LAZR, because I just had the wrong order, but it doesn't matter. I've seen lots of you guys who took it, and I think it's important to discuss this trade a little bit more. So what was going on in LAZR? Intraday news. We don't often see that because, you know, stocks usually come out with news pre-market time or after market time. That's why we have gap ups and gap down when the market is open. So if they have any control about when the news is going to come out, then it's going to be pre-market or after market. But sometimes, in some rare occasions, you will see an intraday news action. There's a way to trade it. And I missed it. It was a several points trade. It could have been amazing for me. Some of you guys enjoyed it, but let's quickly discuss that. Watch LAZR before the news. Look at the volume. There's nothing compared to what happened after the news. Now watch the news, watch the volume after the news. Watch the first candle up here. You see, that was the first candle up. Normally, when you have some intraday news, you will expect a big move up, which was this green candle with a lot of volume. You want to see the volume remains. You don't want to see just one green candle because you never know whether that was news or not. So I asked for a confirmation. One of you guys mentioned that yes, it was some intraday news, something that has to do with Tesla, this Tesla deal they have or something like that. I'm not sure. I just needed the confirmation. I don't care what was the news. I just needed the confirmation that it was intraday news, although it was quite clear because of the big green candle and the volume bar. So when you have an intraday news, you wait for a pullback. It's very, very simple. In fact, it's very simple. You just wait for a pullback and you go long in the direction of the news. Sometimes it's bad news, you go short. You go long in the first available reversal. So here comes the first move up. That's a 1 minute candle. And then comes the red candle, which is the pullback. And then I posted it in the room, or I mentioned it in the room because I don't think I had the time to post it over 3280, or did I post it? I don't know. Anyway, Mentioned it in the room over 3280. Once it moved over 3280, I used the wrong order. But look at the way it works. You always wait for the first pullback. You never join the first green candle. Never ever. Sometimes you'll miss a trade this way because it's just gonna go sky highs and you just missed a fantastic trade. But if you don't have a technical formation, you do not go into this trade, period. You just don't. It's like I'm not shorting a stock that is just coming down and I don't have an entry point. I would never go long unless I have an entry point. You got yourself a stock that is moving up on intraday news. Wait for the first pullback candle and then make a decision where to move in. It's not a rocket science. Really, it's quite simple. Here comes the first candle. Here comes the second red candle pullback. You just wait for it to get close to the highs. You do not move over the highs because over the highs, it will usually run too quickly for you to join. You just make a decision to move before. You need to anticipate the high. The whole idea about day trading is anticipating the next move. It's not joining the crowd. Joining the crowd is the people that went and learned technical analysis for the first week and they are buying over the highs. You don't want to buy when these guys are buying. You want to sell to these guys usually. So the thing is, wait for the pullback, anticipate a new high, go in before it moves to a new high. At the point where you feel like you have like an 80% chance to succeed. Now, this is the tricky part, of course, because if you're just starting out trading, where's exactly the 80% point? Well, you need some more experience. But really, again, it's not rocket science. It's just turning. It has a nice technical formation, a reversal, you can call it, and just go long. And the rest is history. I mean, this stock moved up more than 3 points, I think. I clicked the wrong button. It happens. Sometimes it does. I mentioned several times here in the training room that sometimes you do mistakes, you make money, sometimes you lose money. Sometimes you don't make what you could have lost. That's another option. So that's something that happened to me today. But I've seen lots of you guys who took this trade, so amazing. Fedor, I really enjoyed this day. Not too many trades today for me, just three trades. That main reason is because I started with a loser, BABA, and then I was getting very careful. I really needed the perfect trade to get back to green, although I struggled. ZM was a bit of a struggle. Airbnb was definitely a struggle. But, you know, you do things right more than you do wrong, then you most likely will finish in green. Anyway, traders, thanks a lot. Thank you guys in YouTube for following us. And we will really appreciate if you could give us a thumb up. It's right here, that button. And it helps our channel. It helps the YouTube algorithm to show these videos to more people like you who are interested in trading. And that helps us, helps you. And we'll appreciate it very much if you give us a thumb up. And thank you all, traders. And still happy holidays, because I guess many of you are still on a holiday. And I'll see you all tomorrow. Just enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. Bye-bye.